Chloe, and this is Streaming in the House. Welcome to Streaming in the House. In this episode, we'll explore what's currently streaming on Netflix, YouTube, and a brand new short-form streaming platform, so you can spend less time looking for content to watch and get straight to streaming. Let's jump right in! With the South Korean movie Parasite picking up some of the biggest Oscar awards last year, and the Spanish series La Casa de Papel, or Money Heist, breaking records on Netflix, it's clear that international content is getting more and more well-deserved attention. So in this episode, I want to recommend a fantastic French series currently streaming on Netflix, 10%, which means 10%, and in English they've called it Call My Agent. This comedy that takes place in Paris is about a renowned talent agency and all that lies behind this incredible industry. My dad, who's French, recommended this series to me a few weeks ago, and it wasn't long before I devoured all three seasons. Even if you don't recognize the French superstars that make an appearance in each episode, you are sure to fall in love with every character in this series, along with their development and clever storyline. Check out the trailer for 10% or Call My Agent.
Qu'est-ce qui se passe?
C'est parce que dans le scénario, il y a écrit « l'enlace passionnément, pas il la jette violemment dans les buissons ».
Connasse.
Connard.
Non, c'est pas possible. Tu appelles leurs agents immédiatement.
Donc chaque agent a en moyenne 80 comédiens. On les aide à trouver des rôles, on négocie leurs contrats, on les accompagne dans la gestion de leur carrière. En échange, on prend 10% de la rémunération.
On en est où de Cécile de France pour le Tarantino?
Trop âgé pour le rôle.
Oh, Cécile de France, trop âgé pour un rôle? Et c'est quoi le rôle, un enfant?
Mais c'est hiérochimesque.
Antoine Decaune qui a des problèmes de date de tournage, c'est urgent. Puis bon, bah, il y a Isabelle Adjani, elle a un problème de cheveux et c'est urgentissime.
Le film que je dois faire,
oui, oui.
Je crois que je ne vais pas le faire.
Non, c'est pas possible. C'est pas vrai, ça s'arrête à quel âge, les caprices?
Bonjour Françoise, c'est Andrea Martel. Bonjour Françoise, c'est Andrea Martel. Bonjour Françoise, c'est Andrea Martel.
J'ai...
Ah, putain!
Je pars en vacances au Brésil, hein, pas à la retraite.
Alors tu bois des caipis, des mojitos, tu regardes le cul des filles.
Mais pourquoi juste que je regarde?
Samuel, on est en réunion, t'es sur haut-parleur.
Monsieur Kerr Samuel est décédé. Il aurait avalé une guêpe.
Je vous ai demandé de venir ce soir parce que vous étiez les associés de mon mari. Je veux vendre.
La mère monstrueuse et la fille insupportable.
Je vous interdis de dire que ma fille est insupportable.
Mais ma mère n'est pas monstrueuse. Enfin, mais si je peux pas m'engueuler avec ma mère, avec qui je vais m'engueuler?
C'est une sorte de Bonnie and Clyde chez les octogénaires.
Tu sais que j'aime pas la violence.
Je ne saute pas sur le canard, c'est clair?
Mon cœur, lui, me dit de...
Oh putain, je peux pas jouer comme ça!
Bon, ça me répète.
Cette agence, il y a que des stars.
Te dire qu'il est marié, très marié.
Il n'y a aucune limite entre votre vie professionnelle et votre vie privée.
C'est un monde de requins. Si c'est pas toi qui bouffes les autres, c'est toi qui bouffes.
C'est le fauteuil de Jean Gabin. C'est vous, ma famille. Vous et mes acteurs.
Maïska. Maïska.
Like we've been living under a rock during this pandemic, we are nonetheless very much connected virtually, so it's hard to ignore the kind of 21st century civil rights movement that's taking place right outside our windows. If you're curious to learn a little bit more about how the United States got to where it is today, there is an eye-opening documentary called 13th, which explores the racial inequalities in the United States by focusing on the prison system. This documentary is part of the Black Lives Matter archive on Netflix, but if you don't have Netflix, it's okay, because you can actually watch the entire documentary for free right here through the Netflix YouTube channel. Here's a trailer for 13th.
One out of four human beings with their hands on bars, shackled, in the world, are locked up here in the land of the free.
Khalif Browder was walking home from a party when he was stopped by police.
Then they said, we're gonna take you to the precinct, and most likely we're gonna let you go home, and then I never went home.
13th Amendment to the Constitution makes it unconstitutional for someone to be held as a slave. There are exceptions, including criminals.
The loophole was immediately exploited. What you got after that was a rapid transition to a mythology of black criminality. Some people
got the real problem. Animals, beasts that needed to be controlled.
You better believe it. I'm only
human. It became virtually impossible for a politician to run and appear soft on crime.
The kinds of kids that are called super predators.
Millions of dollars will be allocated for prison and jail facilities.
Three strikes and you are out.
It was an enormous burden on the black community, but it also violated a sense of core fairness.
Some people got the real problem. States were required to keep these prisons filled, even if nobody was committing a crime.
It's so difficult to talk about mass incarceration because it has become heavily monetized. I'm only
human. The focus is on taking people from prison, putting them in community corrections, parole, and probation.
How much progress is it really if now there's a private company making money off the GPS monitor?
Now have more African Americans under criminal supervision than all the slaves back in the 1850s. I'm only
human. We are the products of the history that our ancestors chose. Products of that set of choices that we have to understand in order to escape from it. We should go looking somewhere high.
I'm only human. After all, don't put the blame on me.
Did you know there is a brand new short-form streaming platform out there? It's called Quibi, which stands for Quick Bites, and currently it's only available in the United States and Canada. It was founded in August of 2018 and racked up an impressive $1.75 billion in investment. With this small sum, it has spent the past year creating star-studded short-form content for your phone before making its official and ultimately untimely launch in April of this year. Because of its timing and perhaps for several other reasons, Quibi has had a bit of a rough start, with some negative reviews and articles, and several people insisting that short-form content for your phone is something that nobody wants. But I do. Because personally, I usually don't find time to sit through an entire hour-long series. For example, each episode of Call My Agent lasts an hour long, and I would watch them in increments of about 15 to 30 minutes. And the 13th documentary, I watched it in a time span of 4 days. So personally, I think short-form content is a great idea. Quibi dominated the short-form category in this year's Emmy nominations with a total of 10. Then I saw an ad for Kevin Hart's show on Quibi. Now, I'm a big fan of Kevin Hart, so I decided to give this app a try with its 14-day free trial. Now, the app is incredibly user-friendly, and it also has a technology in which you can watch the content either vertically or horizontally without any problems. Granted, Quibi is currently in a legal battle over this technology, but that's a whole other story. Die Hard includes an A-list cast with Kevin Hart starring as himself, John Travolta, Jean Reno, and Natalie Emmanuel. It is absolutely hysterical. And if you want to take a short break from work, you can watch one episode in 10 minutes. Or if you want to take a bit of a longer break, you can watch 3 episodes for a total of 30 minutes. So far, I personally love this app. Granted, I'm still in the free version, and I'm still watching the series that brought me to download the app in the first place. So we'll see in 2 weeks, once both the free trial and this show have ended, to see if there's enough to keep me there for $4.99 a month with ads or $7.99 a month without ads. For now, check out the trailer for Die Hard on Quibi.
My whole life, I dreamed of becoming an action hero.
Now, Kev, people are just raving about this new movie of yours.
You are working with Dwayne The Rock Johnson, playing his comedy sidekick again.
Here's my question. Why can't I be an action star?
In my car.
No, I'm serious. I don't know why you're laughing. I'm being very serious. Back up!
Yep.
Tell me what I am and what I'm not. This is my time to shine.
Welcome to Ron Wilcox Action Star School. I'm Ron Wilcox.
Rule number one, you are forbidden from visiting the outside world. You'll stay here.
Okay, I get it. shit.
Rule number two, when you're under this roof, your name is no longer Kevin. Have you ever heard an action star leading man ever called Kevin?
I mean, Kevin James and Mark.
No, Kevin is the name of a punk bitch.
Coach Ron is crazy. I'm serious, he's nuts.
I want you to storm the house, find the victim, and bring him to safety. A leading man must learn not to sweat the small stuff.
What are you talking about, the small stuff? I was on fucking fire, Coach Ron!
So, you're just gonna give up on your lifelong dream?
You're right. I need a cowboy to fuck up.
Chitty chitty bang bang, bitch.
Oh yeah. The true action hero is tough. Help! He's confident. They will take responsibility for their shit.
You're like a real life Rambo.
Whoop, there it is. I'm ready right now.
Thank you so much for joining us and streaming In the House. What TV shows, documentaries, movies do you recommend? Leave them in the comments below and don't forget to like this video and subscribe to In the House channel. See you next time. La Casa de Papel or Money Heist, it's Money Heist. Heist? Alexa, how do you pronounce heist? Quibi was founded in August of 2018, and okay. Here we go. Did you know there is a brand new short form streaming platform that launched? No. So I think short form content is a great idea. What else do I think? Oh yeah, I think you should cut. Thank you.